decided not to be there. What do you think of that boycott?
John who?
John Lewis. John Lewis, he was bloodied on the Selma Bridge, Sheriff, when he was trying to protest voting rights and organizing sit-ins and
Lewis,
a variety
and
of things
Lewis
on behalf
become,
of the black community.
Are you going to let me talk, Eboni?
Oh, well,
John
sir,
Lewis,
you were, I was just addressing
you
your question.
Talk,
you asked who, so I was telling you about, a bit about John Lewis.
You didn't let me finish. John Lewis has become one of the most irrelevant members of Congress. Have you taken, Eboni, a look at his congressional district, the high poverty, the high unemployment, the crime that goes on, the failing schools that have gone on in his district under his leadership? Look, nobody cares what John Lewis is doing. He's been reduced to being a caricature in that he has to pull a political stunt like this. He can't even honor the Civil Rights Museum opening. He has to pull a political stunt to get news coverage. That's how bad this is. Look, Donald Trump realizes that he's the president of all people. He also realizes that actions speak louder than words. So his showing up, I think, signals, and what these obstinate people are afraid of, that President Donald Trump is winning hearts and minds quietly and slowly throughout black America, as they are willing to give him a chance, as he asked during the campaign. So I think the event will be better off without those people there.
Well, Sheriff, let me say this to you. For you to say that nobody cares about John Lewis is inaccurate, because I assure you that there are many people across this country that absolutely do care about him. As for your commentary on his political record as a congressman, I'm actually not even addressing that part, because this museum opening is about the civil rights of American citizens. So when it comes to his record on that, Sheriff Clarke, I think it's pretty undisputed.
All right, well, let me say this to you, Eboni, that if you went into any black high school and probably most black colleges in America and talked to black people under the age of 35, they would not know who John Lewis is. I'm not trying to diminish what he did, all right, but I'm talking about today. I'm talking about today. What he did was a political stunt. I think it's a slap in the face. And